How's it going? It's Tuesday, which means Tool Tuesday. We've been working a lot on the fuel system for the Dark Arrow 1, and I've been making fuel lines. Got the fuel pumps here, and I'm going to demonstrate the tools we use to make a fuel line like this, which connects to the discharge of the fuel pump and carries fuel from the fuel pump to the engine. Most of the fuel lines in the Dark Arrow 1 are made out of aluminum tubing like this. This is 3000 series aluminum. It's a 3/8 inch outer diameter tube, 0.035 inch wall thickness. And we take a raw tube like this and turn it into a fuel line like this. This is just an example one. Now this Tool Tuesday is a little bit of a 3-in-1 because there are three tools required to go from an aluminum tube like this to a fuel line like this. First one is a tube cutter. Allows you to cut your tube to length. Next one is a tube bender, which allows us to put bends in the fuel line like that. And the last one is a flare tool, and that allows us to put a flare like this on the end of the tube and then attach a fitting like this. All right, first tool, tube cutter. We're going to use this to cut the tube to length. And I'm gonna demonstrate by cutting the fitting off of this sample fuel line. Now, I've got two different tube cutters. This is a mini tube cutter. This one's about $10. This is a larger tube cutter. This one's about $40. I like this one a lot better, mainly because it has this extra tool on it, which is a built-in reamer and a file, so you can clean up your cut after you make the cut. Tube cutter has a blade right here and two rollers. Start out by putting your tube up against the rollers and then tightening this knob down until the blade contacts the tube, just gently. Then you start spinning the tube cutter around the tube. And as you spin it, each time around, you put a little bit of a tighten on the knob. You keep spinning it and tightening it, and eventually it'll cut through the tube. There you go. After you use your tube cutter to make a cut on your tube, it'll leave a little bit of a sharp folded over edge on the inner diameter of the tube, so you can use the reamer to clean that up. So you just insert the reamer on the inner diameter of the tube, and with a little bit of pressure you spin it, and it cuts off that burr on the inner diameter of the tube. Next step, if you want to make nice little bends like this in the tube, you'll need a tube bender like this. The aluminum tubing is pretty soft, so you can make slight bends by hand, but anything with a really tight radius like this, you'll need a tube bender. If you don't use the tube bender, you risk kinking the tube and collapsing it. This tube bender can do different diameter tubes. That's what each of these three grooves are for. So this is 3/8, 1/4, and 3/16. And we're working with 3/8 outer diameter tube. Principle of operation of this tube bender is pretty straightforward. It has a fixed diameter die, and it basically just wraps the tube around that die. So we're working with 3/8 inch outer diameter. Start off, you insert the tube into the tube bender like this. Close this arm, and then you just start bending. And there are some marks on the tube bender to indicate what angle the bend will be. I'm gonna go with a 90 degree bend. Like that. You open it back up and pull out your tube, and you have a bend. Okay, now we're on to the main event. This is the whole reason I wanted to make this video. I've been thinking about this Tool Tuesday since last week. And the last tool is the tube flare tool. Now, there's two styles that I've seen for making AN style flares on tubing. There's this one and this one. If you're gonna buy one, buy this one. I've used this one. I don't like it. This is the one to get. This one's made by Parker. And it does a 37 degree flare for AN fittings. Get this one. They're basically both the same price. So I'm not even gonna talk about how to use this one. Don't bother. Get this one. I should make one disclaimer. There is a flare tool that looks like this, and you need it if you're going to do steel or titanium tubing, but I'm talking specifically about aluminum tubing. So this is the one for the job. So the flare tool allows you to take a straight tube like this and put a little flare on the end like this, and then you connect it to AN fittings like this. Take your flare tool, and it has these jaws that allow it to grab the tube, and you want them set to the size tube that you're using. So we're using 3/8 inch, so you can see it says 3/8 on the top jaw, 3/8 on the bottom jaw. The way this thing works is you insert the tube in here, the jaws grab it and hold it, and then there's this cone. You spin this knob and it drives the cone down into the tube and flares the end out. The other key feature of this tool is that it has this little pointy thing down in there. That's a stopper, and it allows you to insert the tube and run it up against that, and it basically establishes the correct insertion distance for the tube into the jaws. Before you insert the tube in the jaws, remember to install your AN sleeve and nut. If you don't do that first and you put a flare on here, they won't go on the tube. Keep that in mind. Got my fittings installed in the tube. I'll insert it in the jaws until it runs into that little stopper and close the jaws. Like that. Close this up, tighten it until it's just snug. Got the tube all closed in here, tightened down. Now you're going to start tightening this cone into the tube. One thing I should note, you want to lubricate this cone with a little grease or oil so that it doesn't stick on the aluminum tube and start galling up the metal. So you tighten this, and the instructions say you tighten it until you feel a slight resistance. Now, I don't know what that means. I wish they gave a torque spec, but that's all they say. So the best thing you can do is just play around, do a bunch of these for practice, and learn what a slight resistance feels like. So after you get your slight resistance, you back it back off, open it up, and take your tube out, and put a flare on there. Now you can attach it to your fitting. You got a fuel line. That's about it. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something. I'll put links in the description of this video to all the tools I used. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. See ya.